Excellent. Good morning. How are you? I hope you all are safe. Stay home, stay safe. Children, suppose you are counting number of pages in our book or number of pens in our box. You are using numbers 1, 2, 3, so on. These numbers are called counting numbers. These counting numbers, the other name is natural numbers. The natural numbers are denoted by the letter capital N in English alphabet. Children, the natural numbers along with zero. The new set of numbers are called whole numbers. Natural numbers along with zero are called whole numbers. Whole numbers are denoted by the letter W. So W, the whole numbers. Additional here, zero is there other than natural numbers. In the whole numbers, zero is the smallest whole number. In the natural numbers, the smallest natural number is 1. In these two sets, you cannot say about the largest number. Hello children, today I am explaining about successor, predecessor and properties of whole number. Before you know, just before number, just after number. Just before number means you subtract 1 from the given number. Just after number means by adding 1 to the given number. Just after number is called successor. Successor means by adding 1 to the given whole number, the obtained number is called its successor. Same, just before number is called predecessor. The predecessor is obtained by subtract 1 from the given whole number. The obtained number is called predecessor. Hello children. By finding the successor and predecessor of whole numbers, successor means by adding 1 to the given whole number. Predecessor means by subtracting 1 from the given whole number. All whole numbers having the successor. Every whole number having the successor. Except 0, the remaining all whole numbers having the predecessor. Because in the whole numbers, 0 has no predecessor. The predecessor of 0 is minus 1. In the whole numbers, there is no negative numbers. So, in the whole numbers, except 0, all whole numbers having the predecessor and each and every whole number having successor. In the natural numbers, all natural numbers are whole numbers, but all whole numbers are not natural numbers, because all natural numbers means 1, 2, 3, so on. These all are there in the whole number set, but in the whole number set, 0 is there, but in the natural numbers, 0 is not there. So, all natural numbers are whole numbers, but all whole numbers are not natural numbers. For example, the successor of 10,999. The successor of 10,099, successor means by adding 1. By adding 1 to this number, you will get 11,000. 11,000 is successor of 10,999. The same way, the predecessor of 11,000. Predecessor means subtract 1 from the given number. Here given number is 11,000. To subtract 1 from this number, you will get 10,999. 10,999 is predecessor of 11,000. Properties of whole numbers. Properties: closure property, commutative property, associative property, identity and distributive property under 4 fundamental operations. But the whole numbers only to satisfies addition and multiplication under closure, commutative, associative, identity and distributivity property. Closure property. Closure property of whole numbers. Sum of two whole numbers is a whole number. Then the whole numbers are satisfies closure property under addition. So here 4 plus 5, 4 and 5 are a whole numbers, and the result also 9 whole number. Next, multiplicative of whole numbers. The product of two whole numbers is a whole number. Then the whole numbers are satisfies closure property under multiplication. For example, 4 into 5. 4 and 5 are a whole numbers. The product also 20 is also a whole number. So the whole numbers are satisfies closure property under addition and multiplication. Subtraction of whole numbers. Subtraction property. The difference of two whole numbers is not a whole number. Not in all conditions. For example, here the 5 minus 3. 5 is a whole number, 3 is a whole number. The difference is 2 is a whole number. But 3 minus 5. So in this condition, the difference is minus 2. Minus 2 means here negative numbers are not there in the whole number set. That's why the difference of two whole numbers is not a whole number. So the subtraction property is not satisfied under subtraction in the whole numbers. Next, division. Divide any two whole numbers, quotient is not a whole number. For example, 8 divided by 4, the quotient is 2. 2 is a whole number. But 4 divided by 8, the quotient is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is a fractional number. This number, the fractional numbers are not there in the whole number sets. Therefore, the whole numbers are not satisfies closure property under subtraction and division. Division by zero is not defined. Next property, commutative property. Commutative property of whole numbers under addition. If you A and B are two whole numbers, if you add any two whole numbers in any order, first number to second number or second number to first number. So here, A and B are two whole numbers. First you add A plus B is equal to B plus A. If you add any two whole numbers in any order, the result will be same. Then the whole numbers are satisfies commutative property under addition. Multiplication. If you multiply any two whole numbers, the product is same. If A and B are two whole numbers, A into B is equal to B into A. For example, 2 into 3, 6. 3 into 2 also 6. The product is same. Therefore, the whole numbers are satisfies commutative property under addition and multiplication. Subtraction. If you take any two whole numbers A and B, A minus B is not equal to B minus A. Suppose here 2 minus 3, the result is minus 1. 3 minus 2, the result is 1. Minus 1 is not equal to 1. So the whole numbers are not commutative under subtraction. In the same way, the division. If A and B are two whole numbers, A by B. Suppose here A value is 2 by 3 is not equal to 3 by 2. These two numerators are not equal and denominators also not equal. Therefore, the whole numbers are not commutative under subtraction and division. Next property is associative property. Associative property. If A, B and C are three whole numbers, first you add the first two whole numbers, then adding the third number. Otherwise, if you add the second and third numbers, then add the first number. But the result is same. A plus B plus of C is equal to A plus of B plus C. Here, for example, the A value is equal to B value is equal to 3 and C value is equal to 4. First you add 2 plus 3. 2 plus 3 is equal to 5, then adding the third number 4. The result is 9. Otherwise, first you add the 3 and 4. 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. Then adding the first number 2, the result is 9. So, if you take any three whole numbers by grouping any two whole numbers first and then adding the third number, you will get the same result. So, the whole numbers are associative under addition. Next, multiplication. If A, B and C are three whole numbers, first you multiply first two whole numbers, then multiplying the third number. Otherwise, first you multiplying second and third whole number, then multiplying the first whole number. Then the result will be same. So here 2 into 3, 6, then multiply the third whole number, 4, the result is, product is 24. Then here, first you multiplying 3 and 4, then multiplying by the 2, the result will be 24. Therefore, the whole numbers are satisfies associative property under addition and multiplication. Associative property under subtraction. In the say, if A, B and C are three whole numbers, A minus B minus of C is not equal to A minus of B minus C. For example, here 5 minus 2. First you subtract 2 from 5, you will get 3. Again, 1 subtract from 3, the result will be 2. Otherwise, first you subtract 1 from 2, you will get minus 1. Again, 1 subtract from 5, you will get the result is 4. But here, they are both are not same. Therefore, the subtraction of whole numbers are not associative under subtraction. Next, division. If A, B and C are three whole numbers, A divided by B divided by C is not equal to A divided by B divided by C. For example, here 6 divided by 3, quotient is 2, again divided by 2, you will get the 1. Here, the 3 divided by 2, you will get the fractional number 3 by 2. Again, 6 is divided by the 3 by 2, the quotient is 4. Therefore, the whole numbers are not satisfies associative property under subtraction and division. Next property is additive identity. When you add 0 to any whole number, you get the same whole number again. Thus, 0 is called an identity element for whole numbers under addition. So here, by adding 0 to 5 or 0 plus 5, the result is 5. So here, additive identity is 0. 0 is called additive identity. Next, multiplicative identity. The multiplicative identity property states that any time you multiply a number by 1, the product is the original number. If you multiply by any number by 1, again you will get the same number. Here 1 is called the multiplicative identity for whole numbers. Children, here additive identity for whole numbers is 0, multiplicative identity for whole numbers is 1. Children's next property is distributivity property. Distributive of multiplication over addition. Here A into B plus C is equal to A into B plus A into C. For example, here A value is equal to B value is equal to 3 and C value is equal to 5. Now you are doing LHS, A into B plus C. First you are adding B plus C value, then multiplying by A, then you will get the 16. In the RHS, first you multiplying A into B plus A into C. Here 2 into 3 plus 2 into 5. Here 2 3s are 6 plus 2 into 5 is equal to 10. Here also 16. So distributive property LHS is equal to RHS. Distributive of multiplication over subtraction. Here A into B minus C is equal to A into B minus of A into C. Here also A value 2, B value is equal to 5, C value is equal to C. First you subtract 2 from 5, then multiplying by A value, you will get 6. Otherwise here, in the RHS, first you multiplying 2 5s, A into B is equal to 10, A into C is equal to 2 sir 4. Now 10 minus 4 is equal to 6. Therefore here LHS value is equal to RHS. So distributivity of multiplication over subtraction. Children's, in this whole number chapter, you will learn about successor, predecessor and properties of whole number. Successor means by adding 1 to the previous given whole number, obtained number is called successor. Predecessor means by subtracting 1 from the given whole number, the obtained number is called predecessor. You know which is the smallest whole number? The smallest whole number is
0.
The smallest natural number is 1. All natural numbers are whole numbers, but all whole numbers are not natural numbers. Next, unit identity element is 0 for whole numbers. Multiplicative identity for the whole numbers is 1. And how to find the number of whole numbers in between the two whole numbers? Suppose here, in between the whole numbers 23 and 54, how many whole numbers are there in between? 54 minus 23, and again to subtract 1 from that result, you will get a number of whole numbers. Okay, children? Thank you.